on these bigger sections, the spindles, I always mark the centres, as with nose, etc. Everybody's got their own little methods for making this a quick process. For all the popular sizes, I've got these little templates, just a hole for the brad. Perfect every time. There we go. Okay, I'll try and talk over the extraction. This blank is pre-marked for the shoulders. I normally put it in when it's when the lathe's running. First thing is pommel. Cut slightly to the side of the line. Drop and go is an inch and a quarter. And that's the size is an overhand grip. I think that's fall back from when I started when there was no eye protection. And it's just a habit I don't seem to break. Storyboard is just pins knocked in the important point, and then filed up to a point. And the first thing we always do is reduce diameter, size the calipers. You can size all the points if you're not confident of getting accurate. Quite lucky, I've got a good eye and can size most things. This bead back to the pommel, so I can't twist this skew as normal. I have to use the point. Major for the depth required. In the middle, they're not so deep, and the edge of the bar. Turn the bead. Edge of the bar. Straight work slight angle. Then this side has to mirror the other side of the bead. Down here, this bead is reduced, and this one again, close to the pommel, so I use my point, move the handle. You can always do that with a gouge. That reduced bead there, I'm confident from experience of getting that smack on the rod diameter. If not, you would size it beforehand. Half inch in the gauge. A quirt, in the toes. I always drop up first to the size and then fine cut. Do the clean cut. And when turning, I don't look at the tool, I look at the top edge here, so I can see the shape. Short bars first. a couple of very heavy cuts. Then a nice fine cut. These are very aggressive cuts for the skin. You can always use your roughing gouge to do that. Final cut is always that lighter cut, which gives the superior finish. You have a quick check over before sanding. All okay. I start with 180. Sanding is very important. Have a beautifully made turned item, badly sanded ruins it. Now, you'll probably see me quite often. I just squeeze the paper to make it into a point, a very fine point, so I can get into the tight angles without rounding off the crisp edges. One of the reasons I use paper rather than material backed sandpaper, which I find is a bit thicker and harder. To actually get into the crannies. You don't want to take off them crisp edges, which sets hand wood turning apart and copy laid here. That's why they come out, because of the quality rather than the cost. There's over 100 of these. So that's sanded to 240, which basically is more than enough for something that's been sanded. You don't have to buff it like that with the shavings, but it just gives that final touch. And there you have it, beautifully crisp turning.